Nancy, we're ready for the demonstration.
Thank you, Latoya. I just want to let you know that the reason why I'm so passionate about this awareness campaign and it touches my heart is because I have Latoya, my daughter, and other females in my life that I love so much. And when it was first introduced to me, it was introduced by Damon Crump, which is one of our founders. And what he did was show us the difference between Exhibit B and Exhibit A. Exhibit B, if you notice, it has openings. I can stick my fingers in it, and it's not sealed completely shut. And the reason why it's not sealed completely shut is because the glue, the adhesive that is on this pad, is made from duct tape. It's commercial grade. So if we were to put it in our purse, it could potentially, it'll blow up, it could potentially pop. And if you notice, the thickness of this pad, how thick it is, and it's supposed to be a pad that holds you and keeps you dry for 10 hours. And it's a leading brand. Our pad, if you notice the difference, it's thin and it's completely sealed. When you go to the hospital, anything you get from the hospital is going to be completely sealed, which is going to make it sanitary. So we call this unsanitary pads and we call these sanitary pads. Again, you can notice the difference in the thickness. This one is thick, and this one is flatter and thinner. This one is also made out of a synthetic material on the top, and this one is made out of cotton. A lot of women have said that the rayon, the synthetic material, has caused rashes and irritations to their private areas. We know that cotton is not going to do that. The OBGYN doctors that we've spoken to have said that on the norm, women release 15 to 50 milliliters of fluid. So we're going to simulate that right now for you. Some women release more, some women release less. I'm gonna have a friend of mine from the audience to come up and validate that this is 50 milliliters. Michelle, can you tell me if this is 50?
Yes.
And I'm going to do the same thing for Exhibit A. Is that 50?
Yes.
I'm very passionate about this awareness campaign that we have because thousands of women are undergoing unnecessary hysterectomies. More hysterectomies that is even, that has been in the past few years. And it's because of the makeup of the pads. And I'm not trying to make any medical claims, and I really would like for everyone to do their research, and they could research on WebMD or PubMed.net and find out how sanitary pads are made and link it into toxins. also going to have my friend Michelle come up and test the difference between the pads. If she could press down hard on that first one, on Exhibit B. And her hand is wet. And notice the napkin is also wet. Michelle, if you can do the same thing for Exhibit A. And she's using pressure. And her hand is dry. And if you see the difference between Exhibit B and Exhibit A, which one would you prefer to be in? Which one do you think would be more comfortable? We all know the answer to that. I'm going to go a step further now, and I'm going to take apart the pads so you can see exactly what it's made of. This will be for Exhibit B. And this one will be for Exhibit A. And we can see that there is a difference in the amount in the glass. Exhibit B, again, the material is made out of synthetic rayon. You see how it stretches? That's because it is synthetic and it's no good and it's rough on the skin. Could you come validate this for me, Michelle? It's rough. So again, a lot of women have claimed that it's caused rashes on their area during their cycle because it gets wet and it's rough. This is their so-called absorbency. All this is, that pretty design, all it is blue dye. Blue dye is not good for us. Blue, yellow, red dye is not good to come into our system. And this, the core of their pads, it's made out of old newspaper, wood chip, pulp, trash. Nobody wants to wear garbage in their private area. So I'm going to put this in the least amount of liquid along with their absorbency strip so we can see how well it absorbs. This is nothing but garbage bags. All it is plastic. I can literally put this on someone's face and suffocate them and kill them because they won't be able to breathe. So if they can't breathe, could you imagine how much we can't breathe down there? So we are already exuding 98.5 degrees in heat. So we have the heat, we have our flow. Some women urine, some women polyps, blood clots, and there's nothing breathing. There's nothing allowing us to breathe down there. So what does it do? It produces bacteria. So a lot of women, after their cycle, now they have to have a prescription for yeast infection because of the bacteria. So now we're going to Exhibit A. Exhibit A is cotton. Michelle, could you feel this for me, please? if soft.
Soft.
Is it wet or dry?
Dry.
It's dry.
It's dry.
And if you notice, it tears apart. And you can see the fibers because it's cotton. This right here is our best friend because it is 100% algae and is infused with negative ions. It's also infused with two other ingredients. I can't really remember what it is, the name of it, to be honest with you. However, all three of them, what they do for us is it helps with our pH balance. It helps to remove odor. It helps to, take away the inflammatory, it releases the inflammatory of our uterus. A lot of people, it says it has completely taken away their cramps. Some people, it says that they have reduced their cramps. Personal, my daughter, when she has her period every single month, she has it really bad. She's in her bed, she's crying, she's taking medications, and she just can't do anything else that first day of her cycle. She used our pad, Exhibit A, our premium sanitary napkins, and she did not take any pills. And we had an event to go to, and she was fine. She was still a little bit uncomfortable, but she was still fine. We were able to mingle and have a good time because of the benefits of the negative ions. And do your research, please. Google it, negative ions. You'll see that it's the Earth's vitamins, and you'll see all the benefits that go along with negative ions. Now this part is the paper lading, which is also out of cotton. This part right here, what it does, it draws the water into our absorbency technology. It brings it into this to keep the top layer dry, which is also cotton. Our absorbency layer, Michelle, could you feel that it's just a jelly type? It's a food-based polymer. It's something like what's in the baby's diaper. And it holds its weight 300 times. If we were to put this in a bucket of water and leave it in there for about a minute and a half, it would swell up like a football. I'm going to put this in the cup that has the most water. And if you pay attention to it, you'll see that all it does is soak up the water. Now, our last layer, I'm not sure if you can see, but it has four lines, four strips. If I was to put this over a cup of steaming hot water, you'd be able to see the steam come through the strips. However, if the liquid, if I was to pour liquid over it, it wouldn't come through. That shows that it's a breathing material. And it's also not garbage bags. It breathes, so therefore we don't have no yeast infections, we have no odor, we have no irritation. Now, Exhibit B has been in the cup way longer than Exhibit A. And this is supposed to be able to hold us and keep us dry for 10 hours. And you see all the liquid. Their so-called absorbency strip that's in here is nothing but paper and blue dye. A friend of mine said that she tried to have babies in her 30s and couldn't have babies. She had 3 miscarriages. And the doctor told her uterus was poisoned with dioxin and blue dye. And I forgot to mention, the core of this pad has been bleached. It went through a shredding process, and it's been bleached to make it look white, because again, it's made out of old newspaper and trash and wood pulp. So it had to be bleached so it can be white and pure and look sanitary. But when it gets wet, it releases dioxin into our system. Dioxin, if you look it up on Google, WebMD, PubMed, the first thing you will see is that it's a carcinogen and it's related to cancer. We're not making any medical claims. Please do the research for yourself. Exhibit A, which has been sitting less time than Exhibit B, have no fluid, no liquid at all. Totally soaked it up. And if I was to pour Exhibit B into it, all it would do is soak it up. I really hope that you take the time to do your own research and find out how necessary it is for us to protect our girls, our women, and it's not only for our cycles. Even our older, our elderly loved ones can use it for incontinence issues. So again, if you have any other further questions, we can contact Latoya, and we can go to nowweknow.net to see even more information and get testimonies. Thank you so much.